Welcome to this channel. This channel is for culture and education based on historical and scientific evidence. So, in the past few days, I have shared a video on SOS Wing Chun and Enough is Enough for the movie Wing Chun. After that, I have received many messages from our martial art friends and also Wing Chun friends. The message is asking me to share more on what is really going on, and also some of Wing Chun friends is very interested on the force flow, asking me, why don't I talk about force flow? So today I like to share with you to give you a big picture. So here on everything will be clear for you if you want to really know what is going on. Now, as for one want to follow the path I'm going to share with you, or one want to follow the movie, that is up to everybody. But it's my responsibility or duty to share with you what I'm going to share with you today. Okay? The first thing I like to share with you is a very Chinese concept or culture. It is very Chinese for the past generations, like my sifu, my grandfather generations, today being changed. Okay. So this concept is in Cantonese, it say yao tao, yao mei, yao gao doi. Yao tao, yao mei, meaning that there is a beginning, there's a completion, and that is a responsibility. Yao gao doi is responsibility. So there's a beginning, there is the completion, and that is the responsibility. So when one learning something like learning kung fu, or one promise other people to do something, this is a very important Chinese culture, concept, practice in the ancient, like my grandfather's generations or my teacher's generations. Okay? So it doesn't matter that it is the generations like when my sifu, late Chou Hongchoy, taught me the 1850s Wing Chun, or my Buddha's teacher teach me on Buddhism or Shaolin Kung Fu. Okay. So Yao Tao Yao Mei, there's the beginning and there's the completion. Meaning if one want to learn something, one need to have the preservations to properly study the entire thing from the begin and do up to the end, up to the completion. So when one want to learn something, one need to learn the big picture and learn the details and have the patience to learn it. That's called Yao Tao Yao Mei. So when one do something for other people, helping other people, it's also carried through those kinds of culture. Like if I'm going to help you, if I promise to help you, then from the beginning and to the end, to the completions, I need to do it properly for every details and everything I can think about. So that's called Yao Tao, Yao Mei. Yao Gao Doi is responsible. So in today's language is like if we work Say if we work as a manager in the in a corporation or a store as a manager. Now, when we work there, we have to responsible to answer to the boss, to our boss, our superior, and also we have to take care of the people who work under us. Okay? And then of course properly be responsible for the executions and the directions of the business. Now, if we have to leave that place, then we have to show everything what we have done and tell everything about what we have done and how we plan and so forth, so that the person who succeed us do not drop the ball. Okay? So that's called yao gao doi. So if somebody ask you to take care of their kids, yao tao yao moi, yao gao doi, meaning that you take care of the kid properly, and then you being responsible for thing until when the mom come back, you tell the mom, I have done this, everything, and so forth. So that is how it is. Now, this is a very important concept, because in the study of Kung Fu, this is a must. Okay? You need to know what is going on, and you need to be responsible. So even at the time you are there, you help people, you take responsible, take responsibility on what it is, and then the day, the time you leave, you need to pass this thing to other people, so nobody drop the ball. So yao tao, yao mei, yao gao dai. This is the way how Chou Hong Choi taught me in Wing Chun. It is not about I'm going to be the grandmaster or the gatekeeper of the style or anything. It is not. It is that. So when the generations pass the art or the technology to the next generations, it is not about, oh, this is the successor and those kind of stuff. It is you get a guy who be able to do the yao tao yao mai yao gao doi. It's like if you want to get a director in your engineering group, you want to get somebody who be able to do the job. Okay, so this is important. It's entirety responsibility. So it's like the Spider-Man movie. Great power comes from great responsibility. It's like that. Okay? So know that when we learn Kung Fu, it's not about just I want to be movie star, I want to be this, I can beat you. The at least in my experience in the past and what I read in the history, this is how it is. Okay? Now, that's the first thing. So it is a commitment if you think about it. And it is not about money. It's not about fame. It's about a commitment as a human. Now, the second concept is there are three levels in Kung Fu. The first level in Cantonese is called sick. Sick means you know. You understand, you recognize, sick. The second is Zheng. Zheng means proficient, good at it. The third is Tong, meaning mastery. So the first is people see who you ask you, sick ni go. Do you recognize this? Do you know this or not? Do you have the understanding or not? And then the second level is the Jing. Are you proficient with this? Okay. So an example is like takedown. Are you proficient? Do you know what is a takedown? Are you proficient with that takedown? In the mastery, meaning that you can change different way of takedown. You can, you, is this a still a takedown, but you can, there's a lot of lively change there. That is the tone. So there's always a six, jing, tone, three level. Okay. In today's equivalent, okay, just give you a reference so you can think about it. Sick, understand, is like, in my experience, it's like when you got a shodan, say in the Olympic judo, you know what it is, you realize it. And then when you got the what second, third dan, if you really go compete and so forth, then that's where you get become really proficient with it. That's Jing. And then there's a long distance up to the Tong, because to Tong or to mastery, you need a lot of insight. So six level is, do you know the basic? Do you know what it is? Jing meaning you proficient in it or not. Tong is, do you have insight so that you be able to flow with it, to change, to be alive. Even though a single takedown, you can have many, many ways to do it, to execute it. While the guy who is proficient with it will really be able to do it fast, but still have some kinds of within some kinds of fixture. People with mastery or tone, they can caught you in surprise. Okay. People's good at it, you still can see, oh, he's going to do takedown. But people who is master in it is meaning that suddenly those things show up. Okay. So that's six, jing, tong. And of course, you need to do sparring, fighting, in order to get to the six or jing or tong. Okay. You want to get to the proficients, you need to go through a lot of time for that. Even for the sake, the knowing, at least you have a free sparring, like say 500 hours or more, or else, I mean, how can you be knowing whatever? So here I can share with you, what is my level? My level is just in the sixth level. I know, I understand what it is because I'm not a professional. You want to be good at it. It's just like if I get a first degree, the shodan, I know this, I practice this, I'm just there. I know, so I know what it is. To be good at it, proficient at it, is another level. To be master it, that's another level. So it's not everybody can be Sifu. It's not like, oh yeah, I learned one set, I learned to do this and demonstrations. Is this, and then it can be Sifu. No, it's not like that. So if you look at like the general Chi Chi Guang, you want to put your army out there to against a Japanese pirate, you have to be at least in the level of at least proficient. You don't train this guy for 2 days, don't even know what is going on, and then you send him out. Okay? So in Chinese Kung Fu today, there's a problem. People playing sets. I have this secret set, that ancient set, that internal set. But do they really even sick knowing what is going on there? So this is important to share with you. Okay? So you need to know the standard there. This is not a movie. And this is not just to study, mimic some move. And if one want to be a master, not even grandmaster, as what I have shared with you, the requirement, okay? If you are not up to that level, call yourself grandmaster. That is just get laughed at by those who know. And if you use this three level, the six Cheng Tong, you look at today's around the world, you can see who have it, who don't have it in the martial arts, right? Now, let's talk about Wing Chun. The reality, the truth of Wing Chun is one need to be able to handle the uniqueness of Wing Chun, or else it is not Wing Chun. It may be partial, this and that. It's not even sick or in the level understanding. Now, in order to talk about Wing Chun in the ancient, we need to know one thing. It's based on General Qi Ji Guang's the four momentum zone, or the three group of fighting, namely the long fist, the short strike, and the ground fighting. Now, which is, please watch my video in the SOS Wing Chun. And of course, there's also the three domain, the upper domain, the middle domain, the lower domain. That is the basic of the Qi Ji Guang, or the traditional Chinese martial arts, which is passing through Qi Ji Guang to Shaolin. Okay. The concept of it is you want to know the route your opponent take. You don't want to engage him, to tangle with him. You're always going for his opening in the three domain, but when you attack, you must not leave any opening unconsidered. Okay, so you watch my video SOS Wing Chun, you can see that. This is the bottom line. This is the bottom line of Chinese Kung Fu for real fight. Now, Wing Chun inherit this. Okay, and however, Wing Chun's uniqueness is short strike, martial arts, short strike. So within this, what I just show you in general, Wing Chun's uniqueness is short strike, which is the opponent there you want to shoot in, and you're the fighting in this range. Okay, and of course, this is a hand, say this is the outer, this is the inner. You can go fight here or here. In or out. Same. Okay? You have to be close, shoot in, and sticking fighting here. Now, so watch, please watch my SOS Wing Chun video. Now, the bottom line of Wing Chun is, as we say before, repeat again, you want to rob the angle, you want to taking his position, attack his lower part of body, you want to stick with his body, pressurize him, and then you want to continues to strike him, okay? And then all strike must not stand in the same position for twice, meaning if I do a strike like that, the second position, it will not be here, it could be here, or it could be here. It must not stand in the same position to strike twice. Thus, they say that you never be able to step in the same flowing water twice. So that is the basic, the basic of the Wing Chun, short strike Wing Chun. So as in the Enough is Enough movie Wing Chun, I have shared that you cover the lower domain, middle domain, and you strike the upper domain, for example, and you watch out not to get deeper to go to your back, and you play that way. So what I just share with you is the basic of Wing Chun. It's just like people who play Western boxing, your jab, your cross, your hook. You have to be good at it. Otherwise, you cannot play. Okay? So this is the reality. Now, so where is force flow come in? Force flow only come in when one say one shoot in and one receiving him. The purpose of that is to handle the force flow is so that one do not get tangled. Remember that? As Chi Chi Guang said, if you resist, you block, then you get tangled there. And when you get tangled there, there is problem. There's a disaster. So force flow is using to untangle. You know where or what you should do or what you should not do in the run. Force flow also use when you landed here, because your head, your leg is attacking, your body is pressurizing, you are this close and you're keeping moving, you are touching, you're actually sticking at him, his body, in the grappling range. That's where force flow is used. Okay, now the reason why I do not get into the force flow stuff lately in the past two videos is because you first need to know what I present just now on the robbing the angle, occupy or take his center gravity, pressurize him with your leg, lower part of the body, attack him with your knees, pressurize him, sticking with his body so that he cannot move, and you strike him continuously. You need to know that first. Force flow is not everything. Knowing force flow without knowing those is knowing nothing. Okay? Force flow is good, it has its place, but you need to know this big picture. So, to elaborate a little bit for you, so the first thing we want to do is, yeah, just to show you here. The first thing we want to do is be able to rob the angle and then to take the position and so forth. So for example, this is going to come straight at me, right? If I pull this way away, it's going to come and shoot at me. So the most important thing here is be able to do this. Okay? So from here, you want to walk into it, okay? You want to walk into it. You be able to rob the angle. Otherwise, you cannot get in. And in order to be able to walk into it, there's a lot of training there, right? Like, for example, like this. I have to be able to walk into it. Get my angle. I have to be able to walk into it when he comes at me, okay, in different way. It's not just like punching like that, chasing this like the sphere there. Instead, you need to be able to walk in, get close. Now, force flow come, say when I'm here. Okay, so for example, all this, I have to be able to sense him. I have to be able to play. Remember on the other video, I shared that on hugging, and you split his strength out, like in the Shulim Tao practice. The entire thing has to be able to do that. Okay? So, that is how force flow is. Okay? So, it never is demonstrations. He have power to me, I can take his strength down, and then I use my mind power to eject and so forth. Or it has to be like Tai Chi, like soft, put a structure and so forth. It's never like that. So it is. Continue, go. That's what you want to train, because that is short strike Wing Chun. So when you get in, that is where you're sensing and everything. It never is Qi Sao in this range, and I can take his force. Well, it's nice to demo. But how can that use in the real fight? If you look at past 60 years, Wing Chun got influenced big time by Tai Chi, by all those playing the force and everything. But it lost its angle, robbing angle, is taking the position, pressurized here, pressurized with the body. All those things and the force flow. But it get into those Tai Chi look like mysterious mind power using your spine and so forth. Well, to a person who don't know martial arts, who is just watching movie and so forth, an ordinary person. Well, you can show them all those structure, power, and so forth. The minute you hit like Xi Xiaodong, not even Mike Tyson, not even Grassi family, you know, it doesn't work. Because those people are at what? At least the proficient level and above. So this has to be clear. So still many Wing Chun friends, when I'm talking force flow, they thinking, oh, the force flow coming to my body, I can flying him like in the movie or in the push hand. No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking when you get in. If I touch his hand, how can I handle my action reaction force so that I don't tangle at him? When I get in here, if the friend is a grappling friend, it's going to be struggle here. How am I handle my body? Like I show you with this, right? I'm here. He can be here. How I can say he might go want to go behind my back. So what should I do? Because he's going to change. He's going to go struggle, want to go my back at some case. Or he's going to going down. So what I'm going to do, supposed to do, if I want to attack him or not. Okay? Not to mention that everything first need to be able to angle in when you come in. So this is the reality. So hopefully what I'm sharing with you today, you can see the big picture and pretty much details what's going on. What I'm sharing with you today is not my invention. It is written in the ancient classic, like Qi Ji Guang, Shaolin Sword Strike, 1850s, Wing Chun, and you look at the world, like in the Okinawan Bubishi, it's all in that world. And even if you look at today's world, MMA world, it's like that. Okay? Now, one other thing. If I want to shoot in very fast, I want to play the force flow this close. You need to know how to breathe. Okay? Otherwise, you will not be able to handle the momentum. So again, forget about that standing there. My shooting power can do this internal, that internal. You can stand a few seconds with those people like Xi Xiaodong. Even Xi Xiaodong is not Mike Tyson or the best of Gracie family or the best of Kyokushin or the best of the Thai boxing. You cannot handle it because you are not living in that reality. Even know about this. As we say that the first level was sick. Often we choose not to fight. Why? Because you know there's something you cannot touch. So it often is like this. If you know the other guy is much stronger than you, why do you want to fight? If you know the opponent is as good as you, then there is good enough. You know that you go fight, both will get hurt. If you know that the person have no idea what he's doing, why you want to fight, walk away, you know he's going to not be able to take it. So you don't want to fight. Fighting is not the solutions. Like you have World War I, World War II, World War, all this war and battle. At the end, you have to sit down and resolve it. So that's why, again, this is a Buddhist art. We need to be honest with ourselves, honest with others. And we need to know that we don't want to get cheated by others. In the past 100 years or so, in Chinese martial arts, including Wing Chun, many stories, many baseless stories were made. Like yesterday, a senior sifu sent me an article in Chinese that they found out that the story of this guy who have his iron palm can kill a horse is not a true story. is somebody's speculations. Okay? In Wing Chun, you can see, you can watch video. I can show you at least two video by evidence that people claim that this person is the founder of Wing Chun, that person is the founder of Wing Chun. But you look at them with what I share with you, these two, three videos. You know where they stand. They are not even in the understanding level. Okay? That's how serious it is. So Chinese Kung Fu is going down to the drain due to this past 100 years of everybody have their fantasy, everybody like to promote their teacher. Because they promote their teacher, they become the grandmaster. And that's why I say I go by book. The most I can do is I'm just the knowing state. I'm not even proficient. Not to say that the mastery, where you have insight, you can turn things inside out. People like Mas Oyama, okay? So, this is the reality. It's time to drop all those magic Wing Chun Xiu Lim Tao power or internal power. Sorry. In the reality world, you don't have that. Those are just tricks and those are useless. If you don't believe that, check the history of Thai boxing for past 100 years. So many different Chinese Kung Fu fighter go down there and fight. Many of them claim to have internal and so forth. How much time they last there? How many minutes versus Mas Oyama bring his people there in 1964. Just look at the reality. What is the reality? So if you want to raise up to face the challenge of the rival, like the lyrics in the eyes of tiger, one better know what one dealing with. And finally, to make a video like this today is just a duty. People do not need to take what I'm saying seriously. But for those who want to know the truth and continue on, that's my duty to open this thing up. Not again on this, my grandfather is this grandmaster, the founder of Wing Chun, on this and that and that and that. And after 140 years, what you got? Everybody standing here. What is that? What is that?